If any object moves around the circumference of the circle, then we call it as circular motion. Here, I would like to demonstrate the circular motion. I have taken a constant velocity car, which is tied with a string to the fixed rod. Now, the tension provides the centripetal force. What do you mean by centripetal force? The force which is acting towards the center. Here, this car is moving in a circular path, and the force on the car is always acting towards the center, and that is called centripetal force. And I would like to show you the direction of instantaneous velocity at that particular point by using these arrows. Now, let me demonstrate it, and later on we will analyze the circular motion. You have seen the demonstration of circular motion. Uniform circular motion is an accelerated motion, because even though the magnitude of velocity at any point is same, but the direction of the velocities are continuously changing. So here I have taken three different figures, and by changing the time interval, by reducing the time intervals, here P and P dash are the two points on the circumference which are far off. Next, I made them closer, P and P dash, very close to each other, and here P is coinciding with the P dash. Now we are aiming to derive an expression for the acceleration of that uniform circular motion. Why it will have acceleration? Because there is some change in velocity. Velocity not in the magnitude, but in the direction. So here this r is position vector at P, r dash is the position vector at P dash, v is the velocity vector at P, and v dash is the velocity vector at P dash. Now if I draw the parallel lines to v dash and v, we can draw always the parallel vectors, and then we can take the difference of these two by using the vector triangular law of vector addition. And if you place the delta v vector in such a way that it bisects this angle, then it will be passing through the center. How? Because r is perpendicular to P and r dash is perpendicular to P dash. Now certainly delta V must be perpendicular to delta R. A line which is perpendicular to this chord and at the same time it is bisecting this angle must be passing through the center of the circle. Now here we have done the same arrangement, but only the thing is we have reduced the time interval. Delta T is gradually reduced. Now here when delta T tends to 0, then P and P dash will coincide with each other. At this time we call it as instantaneous acceleration, and in these two cases it is average acceleration. Average acceleration is in the direction of average velocity. So delta A will have the same directions as delta V, because delta A is equal to delta V by T. And we just now talked that delta V vector is bisecting this angle and it is perpendicular to this chord. Therefore, it passes through the center. Now, this when delta V is passing through the center, delta A must be passing through the center. That's why it is called centripetal or center seeking acceleration. Let's derive the formula for centripetal acceleration. We have already discussed three different cases. So now here what we have with us is one triangle consisting of this R's, the other triangle consists of this velocity vectors. So now these two vectors, I mean these two triangles are similar triangles. Why? Because here this R makes 90 degrees with it, and then as tangent and radius will make 90 degrees with each other, and then here also 90 degrees, and then therefore this delta V is also making 90 degrees with the delta R. Now when the two triangles are similar to each other, in that case we can write the ratio of the corresponding sides, they are in proportion. So I can write delta V by V must be equal to what? Delta R by R. Now our aim is to get the acceleration. Therefore we wanted to have delta V term . Now let's take limits on both sides. Limit delta t tends to 0, delta v by delta t is equal to v by r, limit delta t tends to 0, delta r by delta t. We know that this is dv by dt, that is acceleration, and this is dr by dt, that is velocity. Therefore acceleration is equal to v by r times velocity, which gives us v square by r. So a, the magnitude is v square by r, and then we have already said that delta v is perpendicular to delta r. When we place delta V vector on the bisector of this triangle, then if it is placed as it is making 90 degrees, it should pass through the center of it. Therefore, the direction is towards center, or center seeking acceleration. This is only known as centripetal acceleration.